Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Stephen here from Rattle Lessons, and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it. And in today's episode, I'm going to be discussing the five fragrances that I miss wearing the most. So make sure to stay tuned. So, as I'm sure many of you may or may not know, I don't have all of my fragrances on hand. I have about 1,500 fragrances, and I promise you I'm not bragging. I'm actually very embarrassed to admit that sometimes. And so, because of the sheer volume of fragrances that I own, I have them in a separate location. There would absolutely be no place to put them in my current home where I live with my wife and my beautiful daughter. So, there are inevitably going to be some fragrances because of this whole quarantine thing that I do miss smelling and I miss having in my possession. And I kind of wish that I had the opportunity to just smell them again, you know, have them in my possession, put them on, make them my scent of the day. And so I know that once I have access to all of my fragrances again, these are five fragrances that I will inevitably be reaching for. And they also happen to be some of my favorites. And I know you've heard me talk about them on my channel for a long time now, but these are fragrances that I haven't worn in 2+ months. And sometimes when I'm in the mood to wear a particular fragrance, these fragrances sort of come into my mind. But a lot of these are because of recent conversations that I've had with friends. And truth be told, I went on my Fragrantica.com profile and I was looking at all of the fragrances that I own. And I really challenged myself and said, you know, if I were to select five fragrances from this entire catalog, this wardrobe that I would like to wear again, which five would it be? And these are the first five that just resonated with me immediately. So before I begin the video, I do want to very quickly talk about my scent of the day. My scent of the day today is the Orchid Man by Frappan. So this is a recent acquisition of mine. I haven't really spent a whole lot of time with it, so I'm nowhere near being able to shoot a review for my subscribers. But this one is kind of giving me like an Aventus vibe in the opening. And I can tell that this is probably their best seller just because it's a very likable DNA. It opens up very fruity, very bright. It's a sort of modern contemporary Shipra. And funny enough, when I smelled it for the first time, I did get that Aventus vibe, but a part of me was also like, this smells closer to a fragrance by Atelier Cologne called Musk Imperial. And when I looked it up, the perfumer for this one is Jerome Epinet, who I'm fairly confident has done Musk Imperial. I know he's done many Atelier Cologne fragrances as well as Byredo fragrances. He's also even done Vibrant Leather by Zara. So he's actually done some Aventus-ish fragrances, and this one just smells incredible. It has this added note of black pepper in it. So it's very bright, very vibrant, very fruity, but it also has like this dark spicy nuance to it as well. I love this fragrance so much. The Orchid Man by Frappan. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's get into the list. So the first fragrance that I miss wearing the most, so I guess this would come in at the number five spot, is Lolita Lempicka's Eau Masculine. And I know now it's just called Lempicka, very much like Thierry Mugler. Before they were called Thierry Mugler, now they're just called Mugler. I love Eau Masculine. It's one of my favorite fragrances. I initially purchased it back in 2011. I visited Greece. I was in the capital. I was in Athens, where I actually used to live for many years. And I was visiting with my then girlfriend, now wife. And we went into this one store, which is kind of like their version of Macy's, if I'm not mistaken. It's called Hondo Center. And this was one of the more unique bottles that I saw behind the counter. You know, it's kind of like purplish and it's shaped like a tree stump. And I smelled it. And at the time, I know I was really gravitating towards fragrances that were a bit more different and avant-garde. And so it has that really bright burst of licorice with like this vanilla undercurrent. And I said, wow, this smells amazing. And it wasn't your typical, you know, freshy sport flanker fragrance. And I said, I gotta buy this. And so whenever I smell Eau Masculine, it kind of just reminds me of being on summer vacation, spending time with my brother and his girlfriend at the time, spending time with my now wife, and it just has a lot of sentimental value for me. And one thing that you'll notice in this list is a lot of the fragrances that I'm listing off are fragrances that I have a personal connection with, right? There's like a story that's embedded to them. And so the first one is Eau Masculine by Lolita Lempicka. And I'm really missing that fragrance. I would like to smell it again to sort of remind myself what it smells like. The second fragrance that I would like to talk about is a tried and true fragrance. It's a staple in my collection. I know it has been sort of reinvented. They sort of changed the name. They put it in a different bottle. They shifted it to a new collection. So I know connoisseurs and fans of this fragrance are probably having a hard time finding it now, but I'll let you know what it is. The fragrance is by Prada and it's called Infusion Dome. Now, this is the bottle that I own. I have gone through several bottles of this particular fragrance and I love it so much. It smells like the most classy, most expensive bar of soap. It just leaves you feeling super duper duper clean. I know a lot of times when people talk about soapy fragrances, they talk about Prada Lum. Sure. They talk about Mugler Cologne. They talk about Creed's Original Vetiver. And I get it. I understand why all of these fragrances are constantly being mentioned. But in my humble opinion, the soapiest that actually smells like a bar of soap is Infusion Dome by Prada. So what is the fragrance called now? It's called Infusion de Cidre. And it's part of like a more high-end line. I believe the price was increased as well. Don't quote me on that. I recall visiting the second floor of Saks Fifth Avenue in New York City many, many, many times. And whenever I do, it's always the one fragrance that I go to and I smell it again, which is crazy because I own it. So why do I need to smell it again? But of course, it's a fragrance that fortunately, as far as my nose can detect, has not been reformulated because every time that I have smelled it, it just smells the same to me. So I think it was just a change of the presentation and the name and stuff like that. So I guess the number four spot would go to Infusion Dome by Prada, which is now Infusion de Cidre. The fragrance that would come in my number three spot of fragrances that I miss wearing the most is by Versace. And the fragrance is called Versace Mano Fresh. Now, this is a fragrance that I wear time and time again right around the summertime, and it's been actually quite warm over the past few days. It's been in the high 60s, and I've had the opportunity to fire up my grill and cook a few things, so it's really nice being able to get some fresh air and spend some time outside, right? Especially since we've been so locked up indoors. But Versace Mano Fresh is a fragrance that I would always bring with me when I'm on vacation. And I think one of my most fond memories, including that fragrance, is I went on a vacation with my wife to Key West, Florida, and we stayed at this one place called the Douglas Houses. And it was this really nice sort of apartment looking thing where they had like a communal pool and hot tub and stuff like that. I didn't, you know, take advantage of all of the amenities, but I brought that fragrance with me, and I just remember walking on Mallory Square and, you know, watching the street performers and watching the sunset. And of course, you can see Cuba on a really nice day where aren't too many clouds in the air and too much fog. And I just remember smelling Versace Mano Fresh, and it's an incredible, bright, fresh, citrusy fragrance. And I feel honored and blessed that I've actually had the opportunity to host an event with the perfumer, Olivier Cresp, and he told me a little bit about the making of that fragrance, and I totally forgot to bring my bottle so that he can sign it, but I did bring a couple other bottles for him to sign. So Versace Mano Fresh, or Versace, before anybody corrects my pronunciation, Mano Fresh is the fragrance that I'm really, really missing during these times. So the number two spot would go to a fragrance where I'm actually having a hard time classifying it as a niche fragrance because it is a designer brand. I know a lot of these designer brands also have like a privé, a private collection, or a higher tier collection, if you will. But this one particular brand doesn't really differentiate in terms of their fragrances, like having a standard line and then like a private line or anything like that. Anyways, the brand is Comme des Garçons. And I know they make things other than fragrances, obviously. But the one fragrance that I miss wearing from them is Blue Incense. And I didn't get the urge or the impulse to smell this fragrance until yesterday, as a matter of fact. I was on the phone having a conversation with one of my friends, and he asked me if there's any fragrance out there that contains the note of gunpowder, or like a gunpowder accord. And I wasn't able to come up with a fragrance right away. The only one that I thought of was like Spent Musket Oil by D.S. Ndurga, which was like a really old fragrance collaboration that they had done with Brooklyn Dry Goods. I actually bought a bottle of that. It's now discontinued, I'm sure. But I turned around and I said to this friend, That sounds like something that Comme des Garçons would do, you know, create a fragrance with a gunpowder accord. And I told them I would look it up and I would text them the results. And I actually started thinking about the Comme des Garçons fragrances that I own, and I do own a few of them. I have that one, I have Dot. Obviously I have Girl, which is the Pharrell Williams collaboration. I guess that would be their designer level fragrance, right? But I started thinking about Blue Incense and the incense and the pepper and the cardamom, and I'm like, man, I really, really enjoyed that fragrance. And I remember wearing it last autumn of 2019. And obviously now is not necessarily the right time to wear it because it is starting to get a little bit warmer outside, but I absolutely love the way that it smells. And it's definitely a fragrance that I'm gonna be smelling right away as soon as I have access to my fragrances again. And the number one fragrance that I miss wearing the most, it's one of my favorites. You guys have heard me talk about this fragrance over and over again. It's one that I have worn so much of. There's so much memory, so much sentimentality embedded to it that whenever I think about this fragrance, I always just feel very warm. I feel very happy. You know, there's that sort of rush of endorphins like, oh yeah, that was a good time when I wore that fragrance. And the fragrance is by Guerlain, and it's called L'Homme Idéal, which translates to the ideal man. And back in 2015, November of 2015, when I went on my honeymoon with my wife, I ended up visiting this one shop. I don't remember if it was in the Bahamas or the Virgin Islands. It was somewhere, one of the ports that we had docked on when we were on our cruise, our honeymoon cruise. And I remember purchasing this fragrance. It was completely blind. I was just in the mood to buy something. And I said, yeah, this one sounds interesting. I think I remember watching or reading a few reviews on it. And I bought it, and I just love that cocoa, almond, sweet, smooth, powdery, but also like sensual masculine thing that it has going on in there. And it became like an instant favorite. And I remember I would alternate between that fragrance and Creed's Aventus. And so those are pretty much the only two fragrances that I brought with me on my honeymoon cruise. And every time I think about it, I just think about having a very carefree attitude, having a good time, spending time with the person I love, and just living life and enjoying life. And so number one is Guerlain's L'Homme Idéal. I absolutely love that fragrance so much. Just thinking about it now makes me want to make it my scent of the day, but I've already selected my scent of the day, which is the Orchid Man by Frappon. Another excellent fragrance, by the way. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That was it. Those are five designer fragrances that I miss wearing the most. If you would like me to do another video of the style, but maybe like a niche version, just let me know, leave a comment down below. I would be more than happy to do another such video. And I want to thank you all so much for your viewership. I just want to take a moment to say, I hope everybody at home is doing well. I hope you're staying safe and happy. I hope you are, you know, keeping your mental sanity and you're doing things that you love. I know myself personally, I picked up a few hobbies. I've been playing a lot more guitar. I actually purchased a new guitar for myself to sort of try to reinvigorate that passion and play more music and, you know, let those creative juices start flowing a little bit again. So I'm hoping that you at home, you know, that you're also doing something to keep yourself entertained and to retain your mental sanity during this very, very difficult time. So thanks again, everybody, for tuning in. I really appreciate it. Obviously, if you are new to this channel and you took something of value from this video, please do consider subscribing by clicking on that red button in the corner. So this way, whenever I do upload future fragrance-related content, it'll get delivered straight to your feed. You never need to worry about missing any of my future uploads. And of course, that includes top 5 or top 10 videos just like this, but also fragrance reviews, giveaways, unboxings, special guests, and a lot more. Thanks again for tuning in. Love you all. We'll see you next time. Bye.